friends. Welcome back to another episode of Two Idiot Girls. Woo-hoo. So our fun drink for this week, we got a lot of suggestions. I need to combine all of them and write them down. Some of them we're not going to do. Someone said aloe vera drink. I'm not going to do that, queen. Sorry.
I actually have some of those.
An aloe vera drink?
I think so, yeah. Are you thinking they got sent to me. No, I have coconut water too. I know what coconut water is. You looking at me like I can't tell the difference. Like I can't read all of a sudden. No, I think I have some in there. But yeah.
Fine.
Yeah, but we do. Today we have Starbies. The one and only.
Tell the people. Well, mine's easier. I get a pumpkin spice latte venti made with oat milk and no whip because I'm not a sicko.
I used to be that girly. I got kind of tired of them, unfortunately. So I switched to the pumpkin cream cold brew, but I do no vanilla syrup, 3 pumps of sugar-free vanilla, and then I have a little tiny bit of oat milk in there, but it's fire. You know what's funny is I had someone make one of those videos that they were like, this is what Drew drinks at Starbucks, and she got the drink, the exact drink that I just described to you.
Oh, okay.
But she added 6 pumps of sugar-free vanilla. I don't know why, but I was like, girly, I don't get 6. I think she was basing it off the cup size.
Oh,
so she was like, if you get a tall, get 1. If you get a grande, get 3. If you get a venti, get 6. And I was like, no, babe.
No.
I get 3. That will fuck up my stomach.
Yeah, like that will sugar.
Yeah, it churns my insides to have too much sugar like a true old person. And I like can't do it.
Yeah, the other day I got like an iced tea from a Pete's Coffee. I don't know when's the last time I've been there, but I got it was like a hibiscus wild berry, and I said, oh, just put lemonade but no syrup in it.
Yeah,
it was so nasty because I forgot how much I hate the flavor wild berry. You know, wild berry anything tastes like shit.
Teas are like real hit or miss with me.
Sure.
Do you remember when they used to have that white peach one or whatever?
Dude.
That one was fire.
At Starbucks, yeah.
They don't have her anymore.
No.
Kisses to the sky. But that one was fire.
Remember when we went through a pink drink phase during the pandemic? Was it pink drinks?
No, it wasn't.
It was a fun drink. I don't remember
what it was. That white peach one was one that we did.
Not during the pandemic.
No, during the pandemic was when we rediscovered pumpkin spice lattes.
That was discovered. I wouldn't even say
rediscovered. Yeah. Well, I say rediscovered in the sense that we knew they existed. We just never got them.
I thought because I hate pumpkin pie and I'm not afraid to say that.
I love pumpkin pie.
I hate pumpkin pie. So I thought it was going to taste like pumpkin pie and it doesn't.
I love pumpkin flavored anything. And listen, I'll never forget the patriarchy for making me believe that pumpkin spice lattes were trash. I'll never forgive them.
Tell the people.
I'll never forgive them. The pick me inside me was rearing its ugly head when I wouldn't refuse to get that drink. I
feel like that was the final boss was loving pumpkin spice lattes.
Yeah, and admitting it openly. You know what? That shit is fire.
Yeah.
And most men would agree with that if they actually gave it a chance.
Yeah.
It tastes fire. And it's so full.
People say it tastes like candles. Well, maybe you need to grow up.
Chai tastes like candles.
But good one.
But see, like, I went through a chai phase, too.
Chai, I went through a big chai phase because I went to school in Oregon and everyone drinks chai lattes out there. But
and lavender ones.
Dude, yum. Like, when lavender, they bring that to Starbucks, don't talk to me.
Lavender is so popular amongst, like, P&W.
Wait, people. I thought of something else. Oh, wait, I'll save it for my pet peeve. But, but chai hurts my stomach.
Yeah, chai started fucking me up.
I think it's the artificial syrup. I bet if I had like an authentic one, it wouldn't.
Yeah, chai started hurting me a little bit too. I had to give her a break.
Like one time we went to Starbucks and Drew was like on me and I was all venti, make it a venti. And she got me a...
You do that regardless if it's on me. Like every time it's on me. She's acting like she switched up for the day. No.
This was a while ago. Anyways. And I asked you to get me... did I ever mix chai and matcha together? We did, right? Where you get a matcha latte and then you put 3 pumps chai. Of chai.
Yeah.
I took 2 sips and I was like, you have to take me home right now, dude. I think I'm going to shit myself. I've never felt
that.
Like
that really
before.
Do be making you shit yourself.
And then I was like, no more chai. And then I thought it might have been the matcha too.
It was probably a combination of both.
Yeah.
But it fucks my stomach up. Yeah, matcha.
I literally thought I was going to die.
I really love matcha. Like genuinely I do with oat milk and stuff. But like, man, that shit churns my insides,
yeah,
bro.
That's bad.
My stomach feels like a lava lamp when I drink anything
bubble
matcha.
Guts.
Bubble guts. Yeah, literally.
That's true all the time, though.
True. I do be laying on my left side, you know? That gets the gas out for those of you that don't know.
But you have to lay on your flat on your left side, like on the ground. Like, I don't even feel like the bed works.
The bed works for me, but you have to lay any on
your
surface.
Side and then with your arm above your head.
Yeah.
So you're laying on your arm.
that, like, if you feel like you got gas trapped, bro, try it. Lay on your left side. Maybe it's like brujeria or like,
I don't know.
What do you call it? Like,
it's a gazebo.
Like medicine woman work, but like it works every time. Yeah. And like, this is not a joke. When we went to Disneyland the other day, literally last Monday, we went and we ate and the lines are too long.
If she feels like doing that, she doesn't care where we are. I have another story. Go ahead. But yeah.
Yeah. But like we ate and I was so hungry. I ate too fast. Yeah. And obviously one thing about me, I'm going to get a soda. So like I was chugging my soda and I have to drink after every few bites.
That was the same. You have to say that.
I have to drink after every few bites. So I drank a lot of water.
Every single one, not every few, but
I drank a lot of soda and I ate food really, really fast. So
too
like
much air swallowed.
Dude, literally like it was expanding my stomach and I was telling Billy like, oh my God, dude, like my stomach is so tight. Like I really have like, it's like I needed to burp or fart, like either one. And we were walking. I'm like, I just need to sit down for a sec. He's like, okay. So we sat down on the bench and I literally was like on my left side, like laying, like trying, not laying down flat, but like trying to like lay as much
at
as I
Disneyland?
Could.
At Disneyland? Yeah. Dude, wait, what
restaurant?
In
the Carthay Circle. right by the trolley, you know? You know the vibes. So I was like
wait,
sitting there.
Where?
Right when you walk into Disney, California.
Yeah.
Carthay Circle is literally that.
No, I know. But
that,
like where
that fountain.
What were you eating?
I just had regular food. I had the Asian place in right by the pier or whatever. So I had like, I literally had like teriyaki chicken and rice.
I know, but then I'm wondering how you ended up all the way over there to lay down.
Because we walked towards Guardians of the Galaxy, but the line was too long. So then we walked out and then we sat on a bench right there.
By like where they have that little stage where people perform?
Yeah.
Okay.
So I sat down on the bench right there and I was like, and then.
God, you're so embarrassing. Can you imagine you're laying down and people are like, hey, are you Drew?
No, I'm not even kidding. Billy goes, you're too like noticeable to be doing this in public. Like he literally goes, you can't, why are you doing this in public? But it was nighttime. Also, it's nighttime now. Like people can't see me unless they come really
close. People can't see you. Doesn't matter.
And then I was like,
how about it's embarrassing? Don't do that.
And he was like, he goes, I'm going to get up and walk away from you. I was like, you do what you got to do. How about you do you and I'm going to do me. So I literally was like kind of doing it and it helped. It helped like it literally felt like my stomach was going, you know what I'm saying? Like deflating.
Here's my story. It's 2019. Yeah. We're at Drew's first Coachella.
Yeah.
Weekend one. We're waiting for Ariana Grande to come out.
Yeah.
We've eaten Del Taco every night for dinner.
Honestly, I haven't eaten Del Taco
because of this.
Because of that since. It was just too much.
We've eaten Del Taco, had zero water and a lot of alcohol all weekend.
Yeah, dog. Yeah.
And then, so it's the last day we're waiting for Ariana because she's coming on for Sunday.
Yeah.
And Drew is sitting on the ground because she has bubble guts. And then Billy goes, I really want to get Salt and Straw because one thing about Billy, he's going to get a sweet treat.
He is. Especially Salt and Straw. Like, yeah. He would bust it open for Salt and Straw.
So then I told Drew, maybe you should go with him and walking, because you know, walking like moves your stomach
being
around.
Active.
It like helps digestion further.
Yeah.
And she's like, okay. And I told her, but don't get ice cream. And she's like, why would I do that? My stomach hurts.
This is before I stopped, I like really came to terms with being allergic to dairy.
This is like the year, because
this is the year I was fighting.
That
it.
December is when you were fighting for your life in the bathroom.
So that's true.
It was to come. Yeah. We're in April, right?
That was truly rock bottom for me.
Yeah. Like 6 months later, she was going to.
Nothing's
going to
make you give up dairy quite like ruining your Christmas Eve. Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
So anyway, she walks. She comes back, has a chocolate mustache. And were you eating
that's
ice cream?
That's so dramatic. I had an ice cream.
Were you
me.
Eating ice cream? She goes, yeah, I felt better when I got over there. And I'm all, okay. As soon as she gets me, my stomach hurts. I'm all, no wonder it hurts. And she goes, and I'm like, let's sit on the ground and wait till she comes out. She literally flayed her body on the ground. It was laying on her side.
Hey, this is before I was a public person. I could do whatever I want at that point. This is before I was a public person.
So embarrassing.
And I laid down and it worked. And
she was like, don't come sit down here. I've been tooting the whole time. And she kept going, is she out yet? And I'm like, you would know if she came out.
Well, I can't see because I'm laying down.
You can hear. And she goes, well, how will I know? I'm all, shut up, Frank. Kick you in the head, dude. So embarrassing.
This was before I was a public person. So it was more than well. It was a lawless time for me. I could do literally anything. But I did it the other day. So there you go. One thing about me. I'm going to lay on my left side. If I had, listen, if my stomach feels like that, nothing. No one's allowed to do anything.
Oh, my trick is I lay on my stomach and I ball up my fists and I lay on my fists.
That's weird.
You have to like hurt your stomach. There's just some one thing that they do where they like massage your stomach. That's the
only. They literally go like this.
Yeah.
They like massage it with like baby oil. That's the only way my stomach stops hurting. They need your stomach. Yeah. Like, it's really painful, but it fucking works.
That's why when we worked at our office job, I always told Drew her stomach would hurt because we eat hot Cheetos for breakfast. And
yep. Turns out.
And Vietnamese cold brews.
Turns out. It doesn't feel very good when you eat like that all the time.
And then a bagel with butter. And then and then Wendy's 10-piece for lunch.
God damn, bro.
Anyways, so I would tell her, come sit at my desk and I'll punch your stomach. It always helped.
My whole day's ruined if my stomach feels like that. So I'm like, I'm getting rid of this now. Yeah. So I don't take this out on other people.
I will say my stomach doesn't hurt as much as it did last year because I have my anxiety's a lot better.
You and me both. Yeah. You and me both. When I was working at the NFL, yeah, like my was like digestion was terrible. Like
yours is bubble guts though. And then mine, like all of 2020. Remember, I thought I was like allergic to everything and I thought I had all these ailments and stuff.
Yeah.
Turns out I was just in a very,
And stress. Yeah. Stress is the main thing.
It's like it's like a form of like kind of toxicity, but
it is. Yeah. That's how I felt too.
It was like an insane amount of nausea. And one thing about me, I'm emetophobic.
And she's going to be nauseous at the same time.
And I don't want to watch people throw up in front of me. Yeah. So.
And you have, unfortunately, against your will. Oh,
too much. Rip. Too much.
Every time I take Dayson and Billy out anywhere.
Yeah.
They both get drunk and I get tipsy, but I have to watch both of them. I just like
The Virgo in you.
Yeah. I just like can't let myself let go for because I want to make sure they're both okay. They're both more than capable of taking care of themselves. They're not sloppy at all.
She's a control freak.
Like yeah, that. Yeah. Essentially, I just like need to make sure the house isn't burning.
Yeah.
And
except for her house. It's weird.
Except mine. Who cares about mine?
Yeah.
But every single time we do that and like we go and have a good time and everyone gets
Billy
drunk,
ruins it.
No, he doesn't ruin it. Just kidding. He scares Dayson because he goes too hard and then he tells me, I think I have to throw up. And then immediately she sobers up and she doesn't want to be near us anymore.
No.
And then I have to tell Billy, you're scaring my sister.
He's done
Stop.
It to me twice. And I hate it.
And it's funny because before that, they're like having so much fun. Yeah. And then it's when we're going home, like the night's over. And like we have to go back to our rooms and I literally have to tell Billy, you're fine. You're scaring my sister. Stop.
It's too much. And I don't like it. And
then he's like, he goes, okay. Cause he's a mind over matter person. Like he literally, if he's sick, he tells himself, I'm not sick. And then he's not sick.
Man,
I can't fucking relate.
What a brain.
I fucking wish, dude. One time we went
you're not sad. And my brain goes, yes, you are. I knew it.
Me too. One time we went to Disneyland and Billy had full on food poisoning. He rode rides all day, took pictures with us. Like he had so much fun. He ate and all that shit. And he was literally like, because he was telling himself he wasn't sick. That's insane. That's a superpower.
Yeah.
As soon as we got home, violently ill. He had such a terrible food poisoning / flu for like a week and a half.
Yeah.
It got so bad to the point where I thought I would have to take him to the hospital. Yeah. But then he kind of came out the other side. But he all day rode roller coasters. He was eating treats. He was
so
like
funny
in all the pictures. And then as soon as he got home, SpongeBob with the suds.
Yeah.
Immediately.
Dude, okay. So
poor baby.
Someone commented. We were on Two Hot Takes this
yes,
past week.
We were.
So fun.
Make Everyone sure y'all
watched,
go watch.
Yeah, so much fun. We love Morgan and Justin. Mm-hmm. And the Instagram post, someone put take a shot every time Dayson says yeah. And then I was made me feel really insecure because I do say it a lot. But that's why I let people know I'm listening. And then it made me laugh because Mayo, he's like this. He's like, if I could write a phrase for you, like if you were like a celebrity, I would just put, yeah. And I'm like, gosh, dang it. It follows me everywhere. So
you want me
like
to make
hyper
you,
aware
you want me to
it.
Make you feel better?
What?
On my show, I got a comment that to this day I still think about. This was like halfway through season one.
Okay.
And we're about to finish season two.
See, now I just want to nod, but I want the people listening to know I'm listening to you.
So, someone, well, also we're on a podcast. So like you have to say yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
No, someone left a comment and said that I always say, I think it was like, yeah, that's my thing too. Cause see, like for me, yeah. I have like some sort of transitionary sentence, but it's always the same. I can't remember exactly what it is. Probably because I beat it out of my own head because I was telling myself, I can't say that anymore.
Yeah.
And then they said, I reference a story that I already told.
Sure.
And they were like, yeah, like, girl, I love you so much, but get new stories. Bitch, I'm only 27. I only have so many stories. You know how many fucking episodes I filmed?
Yeah.
And you know how many people I meet? You know what's so funny? Everyone I meet on my show, 9 times out of 10, they're someone I just met that day. Mm-hmm. I have never met them. So the stories always hit. So fuck you. Because, you know, you have a highlight reel that you tell your friends or new people.
Yeah.
So now I've tried to make it like a habit to like think of new shit to say. But you try filming fucking 40 episodes and you tell me if you run out of shit to say, bitch.
You know, in addition to that.
Like you're yeah, I'm literally like, exactly. And now we're going to move on. Like, you want me to be wooden? Like, girl, go fuck yourself. But honestly, the joke's on me because it worked. Like, I was like, oh, no. So now when I'm on my show, I'm actively thinking of new things to say or like new stories to tell. But also, we don't really plan what we're going to say. So I don't know what they're going to say. I have to like come up with it on the spot.
Yeah, it's definitely a much more natural. Just like this. It's very natural.
And yeah,
like,
it's just a conversation.
Yeah.
Girl.
Shut your trap.
Shut it.
All right, we're going to start getting to these pet peeves.
Yes.
A lot of them I agree with. I've read a few of them, but I just discovered a new one.
Okay.
That I have, and I thought of it yesterday.
Okay.
Are you caught up on the Great British Bake Off?
Yes. Well, I didn't finish Mexican week. Listen.
Oh, dude. Okay. Yeah. We have let's talk about this.
Let's talk about it.
My pet peeve is when people are racist.
Yeah. Let's talk about it. I almost finished it. I'm on the last... The last challenge. I haven't finished the episode.
If I'm being honest, with all the racist stuff aside, I thought it was like the worst episode I've seen.
I agree. And I'll say this. I think that the bakers and the judges were not offensive.
No, just the host.
Just the host. And it's so fucking upsetting to me. I'm like, it's funny because y'all don't need to be there. That's the crazy part. Like the other people need to be there. And I love Noel, so I was extra disappointed.
Me too. I've never liked Matt. Me either.
Yeah, I don't. He doesn't call to me. I bring Sandy back. Justice for Sandy. But I love Noel. And I was really disappointed to see all this bullshit because I thought that the bakers did a really respectful job.
Oh, Sandy, I do remember her.
I thought that the bakers did a really great job of like being respectful as far as like saying like, I haven't really ate that much Mexican food, but I did a lot of research.
I thought that was nuts because there isn't a lot of Latino people over there.
I thought the same thing, but that's just, again, it's geographical. So like, I get it to an extent. But I do think that the bakers and the judges did a good job of remaining neutral in that sense. They were just like, this is what it is. Mm-hmm. They did some research. Here it is. And like the chance to platform Mexican cuisine is a good thing, I think, but like in a respectful way. So I thought that they did a good job of doing that. The host though, what the fuck, bro? Like some of the jokes were so, and I thought it was just the beginning.
Yeah.
It's like almost throughout the entire thing. Like
with
they
the
say
maracas
these,
and
yeah,
the,
they say this off kilter shit. I like watch and I'm like, what is wrong? You don't need to be there. Like you don't need to say that.
For their, what's the final one called? Their showstopper? Is that the final one?
It's the Tres Leches cake.
No, I know it, but is that what that round is called? The showstopper round?
Yeah. Yeah.
So,
I haven't finished that round.
Well, remember, I can't remember the guy's name, but he was making a Day of the Dead cake.
Yeah.
And then he was like, oh, like, are you trying to make it like happier? And he was like, or what? I can't remember what Matt
said. He says a racist joke about, and then the guy goes, it's to celebrate them. You see what I'm saying? Like, they're like course correcting them because they're like, that's not funny to me.
Mm-hmm.
And then everyone else is like, you know, I didn't really know much, but I did a lot of research.
Yeah.
And this, I found out that this is what they do. So that's what I'm going to do.
Okay.
And I thought that was like nice.
I also thought doing tacos in the technical round.
Well, and also Billy pointed this out too. Like he kept calling the tortilla the taco.
Yeah.
The taco is the, you know what I'm saying? But that's white people shit. Like I just think like at the end of the day, they're colonizers. That's what I always have to tell myself. So it doesn't like enrage me, but it did enrage me.
It's disappointing for sure.
Well, I was just so disappointed. I was like, and that I think is just like almost an ignorance, but it wasn't.
So they've done Mexican week in the past?
No, they haven't. As far as I know.
I thought you said in the car that they have done it.
No, I said that it's a cuisine. So that's why they do a theme because they've done.
Like German week.
They've done
Italian
German.
Week.
They've done Italian. Danish. They've done Italian. They've done Parisian. Like they've done like
I know
those.
That.
They've done like Russian or something. Like they've done themed weeks like that. And typically after bread week, it's always a themed week like that. So I think they were just trying to be like new, but like. What the fuck, bro? I like know. You could have done it and cut out
have
all
they done,
those
like, an
jokes.
Indian one or
no? Me thinks they're never gonna do a brown country ever again. I wouldn't if I were you, like because they did it so disrespectfully. Yeah. Like the hosts, the whole like aura about it. Like I guess like if you're gonna make tacos, like that's fine. too, I guess, but like they have lots of sweet treats that you can bake. Yeah. So I think, again, I think it's just them trying to reach and do something new. But yeah, like it's still like
tacos. And she was like, they don't ever make like savory stuff. When they do, it's like enclosed in something.
They do make savory stuff. That's not true. They do make savory stuff. They have made savory stuff during technical, but like, it just felt on the nose.
I was like, why don't they do a tres leches or something? And then they did it for
And they did pan dulce for the first round. So like, and they all did different kinds of pan dulce.
Which I thought was really cool.
Yeah, and like most of them did conchas. Mm-hmm. They look like shit, if I'm being real. Like, I'm no expert, but like they didn't look right and they didn't taste right. I think they all kind of ate shit on that round, honestly. Yeah. Like none of them really did that well.
No, that one guy that made the boozy ones. Those
did well. And then I think-
the corn girl.
Yeah, she did well. Shabira, I love her. And then the other guy did well too, Abdul. Yeah. He did the besos, like the little-
The two like cookie looking ones. Yeah,
his were good too. But like, other than that, the rest of them kind of did a poor job.
Wait, who's your favorite? Do you like Harush?
I love-
Is that your season name?
Janusz.
Oh, Janusz. I'm sorry.
Yeah, Janusz.
I love Maxine.
Oh, I love her. I hope she does well. She gets real nervy and that makes me nervous. I love Shabira. I love Sandro. I think Sandro's so good.
With the nose ring?
Yeah.
I love him. He's my favorite. Him and Maxi are my favorites.
And then I think Janusz is going all the way. That man came to win. He really did. He came in with game face on.
Yeah.
And I really like Carol too. I think she's fun.
Is she the one with the color
pink hair?
Hair.
Yeah. Yeah. I love her. I think she's sweet.
She's like, how much of this guacamole am I supposed to put on?
Dude, like, and then her slicing the avocado. I saw a lot of people on Twitter being like, it's worse than we thought. And it's the way she was
like, give Carol a break. She's trying her best.
Yeah. But so,
and then I was like, of course it was fucking Carol. I hadn't even watched it yet. And I was like,
Everyone else got the avocado the right way.
Yeah.
So like, she cut it like
the other old lady.
I forget her name.
That made the chili ones.
Yeah.
I told my mom, I was like, that's the most British looking person they've ever had on this show.
No, the funniest part about her was the week, bread week, when they did the smorgasbordin or whatever, where they did savory cake, bread cakes.
I think so.
The week before.
Okay.
And she had tzatziki sauce in hers.
Wait, yeah. Okay.
And they call it tzatziki.
Yeah.
Like over there. I don't know if that's how you actually pronounce it, but that's what they call it.
Yeah.
And then he goes, are you using coriander? Are you using like, and
I don't really like,
she goes,
did
no.
The Greece inspired one, right?
Yeah. She goes, no, I'm making it how I like. And then he goes, you know what it needs when he tries it? Coriander. All of, like he really told her there's no flavor in this shit, bitch. Mm-hmm. Like none at all. And she was like, that's how I like it. That's my favorite part of old people being on the show. They refuse to change. They're like, well, that's how I like it, so that's how I made it. And they just don't care. They're just like,
wait, so you haven't finished this new episode where they try the cakes at the end?
No, I haven't seen it.
Oh, okay. There's but a funny I have part a feeling, with that old lady. There's a funny
yeah,
part.
But I have a feeling I know who's going home.
I already know who went home.
Yeah.
Wait, okay, so here's my pet peeve. So I was watching that episode. It doesn't have to do, it won't spoil who goes home.
Okay.
But I think his name is James. The one that's always laughing really loud.
The one with the glasses?
I don't like.
That. Okay, that guy's low-key good. I think he's like a dark knight. Or dark horse in the race. Mm-hmm. I think he might surprise everyone, but like, yeah.
Yeah, what do you mean? Those little clamshell thingies?
Yeah, and then his concho was ass.
Yeah, he's all, he goes, creativity.
Yeah, he goes, well, I did well on the sugar work. Like, he's just like, whatever.
But I don't like that guy shakes really hard when he laughs.
Oh, when they like vibrate?
That immediately hurt my butt. Whatever you just did right now.
Yeah. I think it's because it gives me fake laugh, but like, what do I know?
That's a pet peeve of mine. I discovered it yesterday.
Yeah, a lot of people think that my laugh is fake. And I was like, that's just because it hurt your feelings. It's all right.
What are you going to do?
Yeah. If you meet any Polynesian person, they all laugh like us. Yeah. Like any Polynesian person, literally, they all laugh the same. That's why I told you I commented on this TikTok once, and it was these Samoan dudes, and they were like, one of them was giving the other one a dance, like he was like performing for him. It looked like they were at like a wedding or something, which was funny.
Yeah.
And so he did it, and the person recording was laughing so loud you could barely hear the song. And then I commented on it, and I go, am I the one recording this video? And they liked my comment. So
that's funny.
That's what I'm saying. All Samoan people, they get it.
Yeah.
They know the fakes. The laugh's not fake because they also have the same laugh. So there you go.
All right. For reals this time, everyone, we're going to get into these pet peeves. Do you have anything you want to share really fast?
I've already shared the sneezing one.
Sure.
That's a pretty big one.
Okay.
You get two. That's it. After that, grow up. is what I say. Or cut your nose off. Honestly, I'd rather you do that than sneeze that much around me.
SpongeBob when he rips his nose off.
It's just something about it just really enrages me. I wish I knew why. No one else knows why.
They all agree with you. You're not the only
one. It's just like, at that point, it feels like it's for attention. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, so stop.
Okay, this first one's from Kira. And she said, I hate when people have no social awareness in stores. I also hate
this. I hate that too, yeah.
I'll be walking down a grocery aisle and they'll just park their cart in the middle of the aisle and cut the whole thing off. It makes me want to slam my cart into theirs. Maybe that's unhinged, but it makes me so irrationally angry. Also, same. Gemini Sun, that makes sense. That's the, those, what is it? Not intrusive. Oh yeah, intrusive thoughts. I almost said impulsive, but intrusive thoughts.
Yeah, impulsive works too.
Yeah.
With that, yeah, I really hate that shit.
Someone posted a TikTok. I think it was Rico Tejido. It was Ricky. Mm-hmm. And they were walking through Disneyland and his friend kept stopping right in front of him while they were walking.
I was going to make that joke. Yeah. Damn.
I mean, like by the he last did time it. Happened, I was literally was like,
move. Yeah, I was literally going to make that. I was literally going to make that joke.
And
I
it's hate always that. Car or and not even strollers. Strollers, they act like they're Fast and Furious.
Strollers will run you down and they don't care. Strollers will literally like run you over and make no mistake for it. Like they really don't care if they hurt you. I get it. Like you're a mom on the go, but also like,
I think we're all on the go.
You know what I'm saying? We're all trying to get there. I thought of one that's kind of in the same vein.
Okay.
I genuinely hate when you're flying and the plane lands.
Yeah.
And then they're like, we're going to taxi at the gate. Everyone stands up immediately as if you don't stand up, you're getting left
on
that plane.
You're not getting off.
You know what? You're going back home. You're going back. You're starting your round trip flight immediately if you don't stand up immediately.
You're not getting off.
The way they stand up and stand behind you like is just, it makes me irrationally upset because I'm like, we all are going to get off the plane. Don't worry. We're all going to get off.
Don't worry. We're all going to get off the plane.
No, truly. And like when we went to New York the last time, remember we were walking on those little like escalators on the floor?
Yeah.
The way that people like...
If you've never been to New York and you fly into JFK specifically, because LaGuardia, for whatever reason, people don't treat you there. From my experience flying in and out of there. At JFK, we land at 1 a.m. New York time.
Yeah.
1 a.m. What are people doing at 1 a.m.? Sleeping.
Yeah. Fuck if I know in New York. But you know what we're doing? Walking through the airport and there's no one there. All the stores are closed. Nobody's really there. There's maybe like one or two flights about to leave.
Yeah.
Nothing really going
on. People are walking as fast as cars on the freeway.
They're running like a full 40 yard dash. Like genuinely, they're sprinting full tilt. Like why? And then I'm thinking, I'm on the escalator. I'm already walking faster than the average person with the help of this machinery. The fact that people are hurtling my suitcase because I'm just taking too long. I can't stand the shit. And honestly, that's a big reason why I didn't like New York for a long time. Cause I'm like, why does everybody walk like that here?
Then we went on a real escalator in Old Navy. Same thing. I'm all, who else is here?
They don't believe in escalators in New York.
Always walking.
Escalators, those are stairs.
Always be walking. That's what they say.
Those are stairs. If you're not using them as stairs, you're a fucking idiot, apparently.
Yeah.
And the way that they like, they so like callously push past you and then they say some mean shit after. Mind you, like I'm not a non-aware person.
Yeah.
When I walk with purpose, bitch. Mm-hmm. Like I walk fast.
I'm aware
around. Never stop in the middle of the street. I don't linger. I don't loiter. And then I get mad because I'm like, you're acting like I'm an old white lady in Target. Like you're treating me as if I'm acting like that and I'm not. And that makes me even more mad. And that happened to us in New York. I told Daisy, I'm like, dude, scoot over. Cause apparently this girl needs to get somewhere because she was up my fucking ass. And then she walks past and she called me a fucking bitch. And I was like,
I know, I want to tell her, where do you possibly need to be at 1 a.m. right now?
Not only that, but like, you're going to call me a fucking bitch and then take off? Sounds like you're a bitch.
If Drew wasn't a public, I was going to say something.
Yeah, but I'm a public person, so I don't want to beef with some random girl in the airport. But at the same time, don't be rude. Like, and we moved out of, I was just like, I'm not going slow. I get people who like, they want to use the little escalator and they just stand in the middle of it.
Then you walk around them. That's fine.
But at the same time, that's what it's there for. If they don't want to walk, they don't have to. It's not illegal. Yeah. It's not against the law to stand on those things. And we weren't even standing. That's what I'm saying. We were walking at a reasonable pace, I would say. That happened to us in Florida too.
Yeah.
Yeah. Some dude.
We flew into Orlando, which if any of you haven't been, I'd never been. So I didn't know when you get off, you have to get on these little shuttles.
Yeah. And Orlando International Airport's fucking huge. So they have these like huge trams that take you from like the gates to the baggage claim. And my mom and I were the only ones that had been there before. So we knew we're walking. mind you, there's a whole bunch of people. Again, it's like one in the fucking morning. Everyone's walking together at a reasonable pace. Nobody's rushing, nothing like that. This guy, like, we're walking and the two trams are about to take off. Like one's going one way, one's going the other. This old white dude walks past, runs over my dad's fucking foot. And then he goes, can you guys move out of the way? Since clearly you don't want to get on the tram, right? Says that shit out loud to my family.
Walks up to the
tram. Walks up to the tram. Doors closed. Like immediately close on him.
And he was like close so fast, like it blew his hair back.
Dog, instant karma. You believe in anything? Believe in karma. Cause I watched it happen.
And then we saw it and I go, oh my God, it left without him.
Yeah, we saw it. My whole family laughs like me, like what we were just saying.
Six of us.
All of us cackling. Laughing. Including my cousin Adam, my hair and makeup artist. All cackling, bitch. We're all laughing. We're like, look how fucking dumb that guy looks. And I was like, turns out we all got on the tram because then another one came and we all got on at the same time. He stood right next to us. So fucking embarrassed. He like, moated. His back was turned to us like he was facing the wall because he was so embarrassed because he really thought he was going to say, he thought he ate. He really thought he was going to say that shit and get away from us. And we rode next to each other. We got off at the same stop. We're still kind of laughing because we didn't say anything, but he knew. And then we got off the tram. He tries to rush off because he's so humiliated. Then he steps on my dad's foot again, like literally runs over my dad's shoe on purpose. My dad almost lost his shoe. And my dad's a big dude. And this guy's really fucking small. And he did that just to be a dick. And it's funny because my dad was the only one not really engaging.
I wish I'd seen that because I would have grabbed his suitcase and thrown it into the wall.
So then me and Billy were behind him. My whole family's in front of us. He runs over my dad's foot again, trips my dad. My dad was like, okay, like, and had to stop. He walks around, tries to take off, right? So then me and Billy goes, that dude did that shit to your dad on purpose. And I was like, I know, I saw it, right? So we walk up behind him. Billy starts rushing behind me. We're holding hands. We go right behind him. Billy steps on his shoe twice. Second time, flat tire immediately. And he kept walking because he's a bitch. That's why he did it. And then the second time he did that and he gave him a flat tire, he goes, oh, sorry about that, dude. Sorry. And he didn't say anything. Didn't even turn his head.
I don't know why he would do it to daddy. Like daddy couldn't pick him up. Like, like King Kong.
Like twiddling his body. He was like the tiniest, oldest white dude. And then when we were walking behind him after like he had done that shit to my dad on purpose, I was literally like, thank God you rushed. Cause like that could have been real embarrassing.
I don't think they were going to let you off the plane.
Honestly, thank God you rushed. That would have been really embarrassing. If you hadn't if you missed the second good one, good thing you got there. Who knows what would have happened?
I think they said,
they literally said,
I heard them. They said,
and he was racist. So that's that on that. But he literally, he was so, but still he had to get like one last lick.
Yeah.
Not on our watch. We made sure of it. We were so far ahead of my family. We had to, after Billy did that, we had to like, he took off again and just left flat tire and everything. Didn't even fix the shoe.
I can't look back. I'm so humiliated. Yeah. Can't look back.
That's committing to the bit to the very end. We were so far ahead. We had to stop and wait for my family to catch up to us. Cause like Billy was like chasing him because he was so mad that he did that to my dad. My dad's the most non-confrontational person. Yeah. Like,
but when he does, it's so scary.
My dad is so like non-confrontational. He like, it takes a lot to really upset my dad. Mm. So like he did that shit to my dad on purpose twice. And my dad was like, dude, come on. Like, you know what I mean? Like he wasn't rattled at all, but Billy was. So that's
That's a good one. People that rush off the plane.
Oh, I hate that shit.
One time I was flying, it was when I was living in New York. I was flying into Oregon by myself. And this guy was like, I think he was sitting behind me and he was trying to get out. And he's like, I'm late for my next flight. And I told the person next to me, I'm late for my next flight too, because I really was. So I stood up and he tried to tell me, I'm late for my next flight. And I said, me too. And put your fucking mask on when you're talking to me. Jesus Christ.
It's funny because same. So
I know me. I'm like, where are you going? He goes, oh, I don't, you know, my next flight. I'm like, you're going to poop your pants is what it sounds like. Just use the bathroom airplane or airplane bathroom.
Yeah. Anyhow.
There's a bunch in here of people who smack their, like chew with their mouth open.
Oh yeah.
That hurts me.
If I can see what you're eating after it's already been put in your mouth, it's too much. Grow up is what I think. I think that's so gross too, because it's just like, there's nothing appealing about it. The way it looks, the way it sounds.
Yeah.
It's just you're 0 for 2. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Close your fucking lips is what I always think.
Yeah. Yeah. Like this person here, Caitlin, she said, people who pass you who are going slow, passing people who are going slow, then they pass you later on speeding in a lower speed limit. Like they didn't slow down in the first place.
Oh my God. In the car. Yeah. I feel that. I feel that. That's so annoying.
This one's from Cass. She said, when people stand too close to me, especially in lineups, and when people listen to music at the beach. Oh, that's a different one. When people listen to music at the beach.
I'm not going to lie to you. I'm one of those people. I get it though. I mean, here's what I will say. It's acceptable, I think, if you're in a party. Like if you're in like a group, a big group, and you have like a little speaker, as long as it's not.
I think it's, if it's loud enough, like you can only hear it when you walk by them.
Exactly.
Or you're like sitting here.
As like, I was just about to say, yeah. As long as it's at a respectful volume, I think that's fine. Honestly, that's a minority thing.
Yeah, she put only if it's stupid loud.
Yeah. Okay. That makes sense.
Like when you're hiking, which or at a park, like I get that. That's
okay.
That's
yeah. That I understand. But like if you're on the beach and you're relatively isolated, like there's not too many people around you and your music's out loud. Like,
yeah,
that's cool. I generally speaking, I like to listen to it on headphones just cause I want to hear it. Like I can't really hear it that well at the beach cause it's so loud.
Yeah.
But like,
yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
But, one thing about someone people, they're going to play a speaker. They'll carry that shit at school. You know what I mean? Agree. I'm sure you've seen Polynesian dudes like with a fucking JBL tied to their backpack.
She also, yeah, she said, when people stand too close to me, I also hate that too.
I hate that too. Sometimes I'll like
at Disneyland. Yeah. For whatever reason, there's something with white women and the men in our family that they think I can stand as close as I want to them.
Yeah.
And they're fine with it.
And it makes Billy and my dad and my brother uncomfortable just because like they're so large that they are already kind of taking up space.
Yeah.
And so like they hate being the center of attention, all three of them. So they like kind of shrink down a little bit. So they're not as like in the way.
Well, Donovan's still learning on how to
he's
not
one of those people that doesn't
always
care.
Be in the way.
But honestly, that kind of makes me laugh because like he's like taking up the space that he's allotted because he's a large human.
Yeah.
Billy and Daddy have been like different. They're different because
they're older too. They're so older. He'll get it. He's
yeah.
Like, yeah.
But yeah, that's I made a skit like that on Instagram Reels. Like yeah. The way that they just stand so close, no matter how close. Like if they know you or they don't, they really don't care. They're gonna press their titties up against your back whether you like it or not. If I feel your nipples on my traps, you're too close to me. Like you're too close to me, bitch. Like
not
too,
your trap. Shut
like
up.
Literally, if there's resting on my shoulders, you're too close to me. If I'm in between your titties, like each one is on my side of my head, like a neck pillow, you're too close to me.
I feel it.
You're too. And most people are smart, smaller than me. Why are they so close to me?
Yeah.
Why are their titties on my neck? Get them off. You know what I'm saying?
How are you doing that?
How? Yeah, I turn around and you're all. You're lifting I turn around and you're 5'2". How is that possible? Were you standing on top? Like literally they might as well get on my neck at yeah. that point. Like we're at a concert, like woo! we're at EDC. Yeah. You just get on my neck. Like at that point, you might as well. I fucking hate that shit. And I'm also big. So like,
yeah,
I really don't like when people stand that close to me either. It's annoying.
No, something about tall people. Cause when I stand by them, they don't do that to me.
Exactly, dude.
I think
it's something
they can
about
see
big
over
people.
Me.
Yeah. Oh my God. Yeah. Maybe the way they like want to look around you. What are you looking at? We've all been on this ride a million times. What are you looking at? More line? You want to see more line? Come on.
This
you know
next I mean? One's from Kylie, and she said, I hate when you're trying to tell someone about some hot celeb tea, and they respond with, I've never understood why people would care about celebrities. Like, they're just people. She put, yeah, people with some juicy goss. I was trying to share to liven up the day, but fine, be boring alone. I hate that.
One thing about Day, she's going to have some tea about
Dude,
a celebrity.
When all the Lesbtopia, lesbian yeah. TikTok drama is happening, I would call Drew with minute to minute of updates. And she always goes, no way. Which one's that? Whatever. Me telling my mom's at my house helping me unpack my closet. And she's all, who is that? And I go, never mind.
That's so, you know never why? Mind. You know what's so annoying about what she said? It's like, it's giving me holier than thou. You're above cheese me? Yeah. I'm not. You know what I'm saying?
One thing about me,
I'm going to be a fucking fika kala.
Yeah, all the Try Guy stuff. I told her, did you know? She goes, which one's which? Because I haven't watched BuzzFeed in 10
and
years.
I only know Eugene. That's like as far as it goes for me. But like, and I love,
yeah.
love. But like, bitch, I was eating it up.
Yeah.
That's why I said
she
that.
Called me. She's like, did you see that video? I go, yeah, dude, I did.
The don't worry, darling shit.
Yeah.
Ate it up. I ate every last morsel. Do I care? No. Is it going to affect me? No. Am I going to watch every single analysis of it? Absolutely. Yes. I watched every single
she
one.
She was like, so JoJo Siwa's dating who? I was all, let me tell you.
Yeah. Something. One thing about, that's why I said it's giving holier than thou.
Yeah.
I don't know why people care so much. I don't know why you're breathing and living here either. You know what I mean? Like, what do you, why, I don't know why the sky's blue. Why do you ask me stupid questions? You know what I'm saying?
I'm trying to think of other drama. I always share stuff with Drew because I'm on
drama in general drama. Is drama. Like, listen, everyone's going to eat it up. I tell Billy drama like he cares and he eats every single bit.
Or if I call Drew on speaker, she's like, he doesn't know who that is. I'm like, okay, so you know this person.
He always wants to listen to the tea also.
Dude, my dad, we got back from Florida. Yeah. So this is after the Don't Worry, Darling, the premiere at a Venice Film Festival, right? Mm-hmm. So we have all seen Chris Pratt getting spit on by Harry Styles at this point for at least a week.
Allegedly.
Whatever.
I don't think it was spit.
We've seen it, right?
Yeah.
My dad, we get back from Florida. This is like a week and a half after it happened. He goes, do you really think that Harry guy spit on Chris Pine? Where is he seeing that?
That's what I'm saying. I'm going to eat it up. Every time. That's why when they say that, they act like they're better than you. That's why.
First of all, you're not better than me.
Yeah, first of all, you think you're better than me or not? Second of all, this is what happened.
Yeah.
Sometimes Billy will come.
So you don't want to know? And they go, well, I mean, yeah, I do.
Sometimes Billy will come home and he'll be like, I saw this on Twitter. What's the deal? Yeah. And I'll be like, oh, bitch, let me tell you. Mm-hmm. I'll share all the tea with him. But like, sometimes he'll come home and he'll be like, I have some tea. Mm-hmm. I go, ooh, girl, spill. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, I'm trying to hear it. Every time, even if I have no idea who they are, I'm trying to hear it.
One at heart, we're both chismosos.
That's why I said you're above cheese, man. I fucking doubt it.
No, you're not.
I doubt it.
Okay, I won't tell you. Either. Well, no, I mean.
Well, especially like with people that are you're never going to see or know.
Yeah.
That's even better.
I know. So they're telling me, no, remember JoJo Siwa? So I'm telling her all this stuff. And at the very end, she goes, I don't know who any of those people are, but.
Man.
Sounds like a lot of drama.
You know what I mean?
This is from Lily. Mm-hmm. And she said, when people are so loud for no damn reason. In high school, there was this kid in my AP language and comp class who would always stand on her chair. And when it was her turn to do popcorn reading, she would read so loud in a British accent. And by loud, I mean like projecting her voice and shouting. And no one found it funny. It was so embarrassing. She was also a major pick me.
Well, you know what I mean?
One thing about us, I don't like when things are too loud.
Oh, I hate
And by
that.
Things, I mean everything. Like, if music is too loud, immediately I shut down.
No, same. It makes me angry.
Yeah. But most especially when people are loud. It makes me so mad.
Especially in close spaces. Yeah. Like Billy found that out about me really early on into dating. Because, like, sometimes he does this thing where he wants to yell.
Yeah. It's almost like he gets zoomies. It's kind of weird.
Yeah, they're literally like zoomies.
Yeah.
And he'll be like, I really want to yell. And I'll be like, go out there and do it. Like, don't do it in here. Cause he knows if he does it and I don't expect it, I'm going to get mad.
Yeah.
So like, I just hate loud noises, like unexpected loud noises. If I go into it knowing there's going to be loud noises.
Yeah, a concert.
Yeah, that doesn't bother me. It's like the random like yelling or screaming of anything.
It's not laughing. So like if we're laughing really loud.
No, laughing. It's just like a jump scare type deal. So it's like screaming, laughing, like yelling of any kind. Mm-hmm. It's like that. Oh, wait. I said laughing, huh?
Yeah.
Not laughing.
Screaming.
Just screaming
or
yelling. Any sort of like aggressive like burst of noise.
In a small enclosed environment.
Yeah, I hate it.
So annoying.
It enrages me.
Like my phone, when it's plugged into my car, it'll like, the volume is different from when I'm talking on the car phone.
I know, that's how it is in my car too.
Or music, which is so irritating. So I hate when I'm talking to you on the phone and then my phone is getting notifications. It's always when I'm on the phone.
Yeah.
And then it's the loudest sound ever. That's when it's texting me. I mean, literally, we were on the phone today and I was like, Jesus, hold on.
Yeah.
And I have to turn this
out. That happened to me too when I'm like listening to music really loud in my car and then someone calls me.
Oh, dude.
And then I forget and I go, okay, love you, bye. And I hang up and then my music starts screaming back at me.
Smash my car.
Like just end it.
Just veer off the side.
Just end it. I don't need to be here.
It makes me so mad.
Yeah, I feel that.
Okay, this next one's from Danielle and she put, people who talk or FaceTime in public and have their phone on speakerphone. Let me tell you something. When I moved to New York, this is like one of the many phrases of mine. People do that all the
time.
I'm
laughing because that enrages me. Like it bothers me. I just think like, what do you want me to hear? Like it almost feels like a flex. Like they want you to hear what they're talking about.
In New York, no one talks like this. Everything's on speakerphone and they're always yelling.
And I just think like, why?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like the way that like I talk way too much personal stuff and way too much shit to be like putting my shit on speakerphone all the time. My phone is never on speaker unless I'm at home.
Yeah.
Like, and even then it's because I'm doing shit.
Even when I park my car and like that fucking car speaker's so loud, I still turn it down.
I did not know that until recently. And then Billy, like, when I say recently, I mean like within the last 2 years. And yeah. Billy told me that. And I was like,
especially in the Prius.
And I told him, you can hear me.
Because it's made out of cardboard.
He goes, I can hear anything, everything from the room.
Even the Tesla.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. I never really use the car phone. I mean, by the time I get home, I just get out. But yeah. The only time I would do that, the only reason I did that was because I wasn't living in my own place at yeah. the time. So I would talk in the car a lot on the phone because I was like, well, I want to finish talking. So I'll just sit in the car. And I used to leave it on speaker.
Or on the car phone. Yeah.
Yeah. But obviously not anymore. Not since I found that out. Terrible news. Turns out people can hear you.
Yeah.
I hate that shit too.
Okay. This one's from Grace. And she said, when girls on TikTok romanticize serial killers and say they can change them.
Something's wrong. Like, I think, if I'm being real, I think that's the ultimate form of a pick me.
You think so?
I think that's a pick me with like mods. You know what I'm saying? Like on Call of Duty. Like, you know, you buy shit to level up your character.
It's like an upgrade.
Yeah. Like, you know, like you buy shit to make them stronger.
Yeah, you use the little points. The yeah. Skill points.
That's yeah. The skill points you earn, you level up his armor.
You think so?
I think so. Because, and this is why.
Okay.
Because men inherently love gore, horror, anything like that. Oh, more than women.
Oh, okay.
When women like it, especially women who exist within the horror space, like whether they're film critics, directors, writers, whatever. Yeah,
special effects.
Yeah, yeah, it's such a small window for women specifically.
Okay.
Let alone minority women of any kind. You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
So I think when women love horror, men are like, what do you like about it? You know what I'm saying? Like they do yeah. to everything. For some reason, I think they've conflated it with literal serial killers, like actual horror, like actual like murder and homicide. Yeah,
not just scary movies.
Not just like a scary movie. I think they've conflated it. So it's all the same to them. So I think when they like romanticize men like that, they romanticize like any sort of homicide or like gory type of anything. They're like, oh, like I'm cool because I like stuff like that.
Interesting.
I like stuff like that. So like, you know, men will find it interesting and cool and quirky of me
wow.
if I like terrible shit, which I'm like, okay, bitch, you're not like a big fan of The Grudge. Like you're talking about an actual man that mm-hmm. murdered people with intent, like intentionally went out seeking
yeah,
people out.
All these families. Yeah.
Yeah. Decimated the lives of many different people. Mm-hmm. Or if you think about the Jeffrey Dahmer shit, like I mean, how, yeah. how he targeted Black and Latino or any sort of minority man
yeah.
on purpose, because he said he knew the cops wouldn't look for them. You're telling me that you're in it. You know what I'm saying? Like, other than the fact that he's fucking disgusting looking, and on you factor in everything he did, like, girl, what are you fucking on? Is what I always think. But like, I think that's like a pick me with mods. Like genuinely.
It's like the hybrid.
Like, yeah. It's yeah. like, it's like a pick me with like, she's got like lots of armor on, you know what I'm saying? Like to that's defeat her, I have to level up my character and get new weapons to defeat yeah. her. You know what I'm saying?
You have to think, yeah, there's a lot of internalized misogyny within most serial killers, other than like Jeffrey Dahmer, who killed specifically men, I guess.
But, yeah.
But
there's bigotry in general.
Yeah. Oh, that's true. All but of I'm them. Just talking about being internally misogynistic, because that's what pick me's.
Yeah. Drive but from. Even like someone like Ted Bundy.
No, I know.
Like, you know, raging racist, raging yeah. misogynist. You yeah. know what I'm saying? Like, with so much hate already built into them, you yeah. factor in the fact that they're literally unhinged mentally,
mm-hmm.
recipe for disaster.
I don't get watching like things about murders and then being like, if he was real to me, which like he is real, he really did kill
that's
people.
The thing that's crazy.
They're like, I could fix him. I see it with like I always talk about Succession. Kendall Roy is like one of the main characters and he's such a shitty person.
But again,
for him, I'm like, I could fix him, right?
In but again, brain. He's not real.
Yeah, there you go.
He's not real. That's why I said they're conflating horror and murder. Like yeah. they're making them the same and they're not. Like when they're like, oh, if he was in real, he was real. Yeah, he was very
that's
real.
So true.
You think about like Richard Ramirez, like that's another one that they were doing for mm-hmm. a while. Like, oh, he's so, first of all, no, he fucking wasn't. Like he was disgusting. And a lot of times cops made up the fact that they were so beautiful and charming because they were poor police work. They weren't doing their fucking jobs and didn't catch yeah, them.
Make them look better in the media.
Yeah, yeah. They didn't catch them when they could have because they overlooked shit. Because they were a man or they were a white man or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, or they're being lazy.
They're killing minority people and they just don't care. Yeah. You see what I'm saying? Like, that's the shit I'm talking about. So they're
like, I didn't do my job, but look how handsome he is.
But that wasn't my fault because he was handsome. That makes no sense. Like, yeah, you see all the shit about Ted Bundy and then you find out that dude was fucking busted from the toes up, bro. Like, he was so ugly, so disgusting. Richard Ramirez, I watched a documentary on him, made me sick, literally. But his mouth was so disgusting. All of his victims that survived said that the one thing they all picked out was the fact that he was missing teeth. They were brown. His breath was rancid. And he was so gross to look at. Every single one of his victims that survived said, the one thing I do remember, his breath was fucking busted, bro.
But they take that one clip of him, that surveillance like thing where it caught him on a good angle. And they're like, sexy. Well,
I'm sorry. He had sunglasses on and his hair was covering half his face. Take the sunglasses and shave the head bald, bitch. And you tell me if that's someone that you're like, ooh la la. Not even factoring what he did. You know what I'm saying? And Richard Ramirez was the scariest one because he didn't target a specific demographic. He was just
going wild, yeah.
Anyone. Literally anyone. And that was the scariest part about him.
There's a serial killer in Stockton. Did you see that?
I heard about that, yeah.
Yeah, that's targeting gay men, I think.
I saw that,
yeah. So make sure you're aware of that, friends, if you live in SoCal.
Well, it's just like, isn't Stockton middle California?
Yeah, but okay, all of California.
Yeah.
West Coast.
Yeah, in general.
Yeah.
But like, I think that is a pick me shit. That's so
interesting.
Because if you think about it, internalized misogyny is in everything. Mm-hmm. So you fantasize and think about a man that committed murder multiple times. Mm-hmm. And it wasn't just murder. Like, they all committed other very serious crimes. Like for example,
essay.
Yeah. Any sort of essay, pedophilia in general, like they did more. They did so much more than just murdering them. Mm-hmm. So if you genuinely believe that this person is attractive and you're attracted to them, you need to go get help. Mm-hmm. First of all, you need to unlearn whatever internalized misogyny is driving that shit. Yeah. But most of all, you need to get help, bitch. Like, you're disgusting if that's the case. I think that's so gross. But that's what I think about girls like that. Like, it's truly like a pygmy with like lots of muscles. You know what I'm saying?
It's a hybrid form. Like, it's outgrown.
It is. It's someone like,
it's an evolved form. Yeah, evolved,
like a Pokemon. You know what I mean? Like, they evolve. Like, that's like, she's like a level 4. You know what I'm saying? So like, that's what I think about women.
So true. I never thought of it like
too
that.
Far gone.
Okay. This one's from Michael. And he said, I'm in a wheelchair and I use public transportation. My pet peeve is when people rush on before me while fully stepping in front of me. It's so annoying. It makes me cringe and I don't know why. I know why. Because it's fucking rude.
Yeah, I know exactly why. You have every right to be annoyed. That's a pet peeve
of mine too. Especially even like, I know we were laughing about strollers at Disneyland. But if I'm getting on an elevator or some sort of bus or the airplane, I'm like, let the stroller get on.
Yeah, relax.
And then we'll all get on.
I think that too about older people, like when I used to ride the bus all the time in college, like if older people came on, I'd give my seat to them. Mm-hmm. I do that all the time.
Same on the, like I would take the subway when I lived in New York and I'd let
I think it's just polite. You know what I mean? You don't owe them anything necessarily, but I just think like we're all riding the bus. It sucks, but like you're older than me, so you're more than welcome to sit down. I'm capable of standing.
When I would sit on the subway, I would put my bag next to me so no one would sit next to me. But if I saw like a lady and her kid come on, I would move it and scoot over and tell them to come sit next to me.
Yeah. Well, yeah, I you have every right to be annoyed. I'd be mad. You should be mad because that's fucking rude. I same thing with any sort of transportation in general, or like you said, the airport. Like public places where there's lots of people. Yeah. If someone's in a wheelchair or something, or someone's on a scooter of any kind, like
get out of the way.
Well, I always let them go first. It's not going to cost you anything. Like, what are you going to be 2 minutes later than you would have been had you not cut them off? Like,
it's 1 a.m. What are we doing?
Yeah. I always hold doors too. Like I hold doors for people if they're either in some sort of like wheelchair or scooter or strollers or anything
or like
that.
Or like a cane or whatever. I
hold doors. Sometimes Billy will hold the door open and he'll stand there for like 3 minutes just holding the door, letting everybody out to the point where people think he works there.
Yeah.
So I have to go back and get him. I'm like, hey, dude, come on, let's go. And he's like, oh, sorry, I was just holding the door.
That's fucking rude, Michael.
Yeah, that is rude.
You need to start yelling at people.
Yeah, you deserve it. You have every right to yell at them.
But I understand why you don't.
If I ever see you, I'll yell at them for you. I'll take care of it for you.
That's horseshit. Okay. This next one's from Matthew. And he said, anytime someone uses a touchscreen of any kind with their middle finger, and I'm talking middle finger full on out.
like they use their middle finger only?
Or do you think they like this? Do you think that irritates him?
Oh, like if they do that.
Like,
oh.
If you see people on TikTok and going like, this is how they're flipping people off, is from the front of their hand instead of like this. They're going like this.
What?
I saw Dom put it on her B-roll and it made me laugh so hard. That's, but they're just going like this.
To be funny.
Yeah.
It's funny because it doesn't look offensive when you do that.
No. But if, as soon as I do that, you're all.
Yeah. That's funny.
But yeah, do you think it's like that or do you think it's like this?
I think they said full on out. So it's probably like
all
that.
All fingers are bent. Sorry for the audio listeners. All fingers are bent. Middle
like you're up. Flipping someone off, or is it just that taking the lead when you put the fingers are
it's
spread
bent forward more than the others?
This wouldn't bother me, but this would bother me.
Yeah.
Like if I had finger like I was flipping someone off and I was using an iPad, that would enrage me.
You're waiting to check in for your flight and the person in front of you is doing that would irritate you.
I would literally be like, what are you doing that for? You know what I'm saying?
Do you
like
want attention?
Like girl, I'm looking at you. You don't need to relax. You know what I'm saying?
Anytime someone annoys you, I'm going to say, what do you want, attention?
I think that's what I think about sneezing. I'm like, do you want attention or something? I already said bless you. What do you want? What else do you want from me?
Okay, this last one we'll end on because it's so funny. So this is Nicole, and she said, I hate when you go to a karaoke bar and the person who sings good gets up and hogs the mic. Is just looking for attention. Go home. These people also sing in the most inappropriate places. Like they try to sing for real, not just for singing.
Oh my God. Like that TikTok you sent me of the girl singing at Billie Eilish's concert.
That was so funny. Her doing her own run.
Yeah. Like she's trying to harmonize with her. Like she's singing one octave above or below her.
And I saw
someone comment, they were like, she was trying to get discovered, which is so funny. That's unbelievable. Listen, if I could have one talent in the world, it would be singing.
Singing.
Yeah, I'm not tone deaf, but I can't sing, and that's okay.
Yeah.
I've come to terms with it. However, I can't promise you that if I could sing, I wouldn't be that person.
Yeah.
Listen, I would take up, you know what I'd be? I'd be like, oh my gosh, guys, come on. No. Okay, fine. Right. And I'd always
like, do you have a Listen by Beyonce on there?
I'd be like, all right, fine. Just cue up Yes by Beyonce. Go ahead. Like I would immediately, like the way I'd perform, like I can't even tell you that I wouldn't do that.
I think I would only do Beyonce songs. Well, do you have XO? Like it just keeps going.
Do you have Girl by Beyonce? The way that I would be insufferable if I had that talent. You guys should be lucky. You should be thanking your lucky stars that God did not give me the gift of singing.
I agree, yeah.
Because if he did, I would be insufferable.
And then you'd be like, listen. Like all small.
Or like when someone else is singing, I'd be harmonizing with them.
Yeah.
Like that girl at Billie Eilish's concert. But I wouldn't do it there. I would do it at a karaoke bar because no one can hear you at the concert except the girl recording. But like at the karaoke bar, everyone can hear you.
Do you know how mad I'd be if I had pit tickets to Billie Eilish?
And I had to listen to that
all
night.
And I didn't realize you could also hear it on my video. I would be so mad.
Till I got home.
Yeah, I'm like, and all you hear is that girl singing. It's so annoying.
That's really bad. Like that's you looking at the girl. Come on, reel it in.
Nothing's more humbling though, watching back your story from the night before
and hearing yourself sing.
Dude, I did that. It's so embarrassing.
I've done that so many times.
When I went to Coachella and I was watching Maggie Rogers by myself because I was drunk and obviously sad. And I was like,
she wasn't alone, by the way.
No. Well, I'm sorry, standing by myself, but Drew and Billy were supervising me from the beer garden.
I was eating pizza and I can't take my food out because I had beer.
Well, it was too hot. So I
had to watch her from a
distance. Please watch me from over there.
Yeah.
And every time I turn around and wave at them.
She wasn't alone. Yeah.
But,
she just wanted to get really close.
Yeah. But I didn't realize you could hear me singing in like two of my videos. I was so embarrassed. That's why I love when Teffy goes to concerts because you always hear her singing in all her videos.
Yeah. I have so many like concerts I've been to where I watch the videos back or like when I would just drunkenly post them on Snapchat and then I'd listen back and I'd be like, oh my God, I'm so embarrassed.
It's so embarrassing.
Because I can't sing. But like, see, I would wield the power wisely, I think. I would still be insufferable. But I would at least do it in the appropriate place.
Yeah, like remember when we left the Sugar Factory in Orlando and they had that bar that was doing karaoke?
Yeah.
And that girl was
That's singing. My time to shine.
Yeah.
That's my outdoor bar. Everyone's drunk. They're going to cheer you on no matter what you sound like. That's my time to shine. If I could sing, but I can't. So I get it though. It is irritating.
Yeah.
Mostly, I think a lot of times too, like it just depends on the time and the place. Like the Billie Eilish concert, too much. Like you could do it a couple times. After that, girl, come on. You know what I mean? It's so bad to the point where you're drawing attention from other people in the crowd. You're doing too much.
Yeah.
In a bad way, in a negative way. It's not like a, get it, girl. You know what I mean?
You're killing it.
You're killing it. She's really good.
She's really good.
It's not like that.
No. Yeah. I just don't understand. I gay people love karaoke so much. I will never do that. I will never stand on a stage and sing.
Samoan people love karaoke.
Yeah, and I will never do it.
Yeah.
I'll go there and watch.
Filipino love people love karaoke. Love karaoke. Yeah. Love karaoke. And Samoan people do too. I don't know if it's just a Pacific thing.
I think it's because they're all good at singing. I think
that's true. That's true. So many of my cousins are so fucking talented.
They'll go
at singing.
Rent those little rooms and I'm invite me because I know you'll peer pressure me into singing.
And they're outperforming each other, but they're singing and they're doing all the harmonies and shit. Yeah. And I'm like, I can't join in.
There's only one microphone, but all of them are singing at the same time.
When it comes to that, I'm a classified hater. Yeah. Like, I'm just a hater at that point.
They're not even that good. I certainly.
Whatever.
Yeah.
Okay, we get it. You can
Everyone
sing.
Can sing that song.
Okay, we get it. So, yeah.
All right, friends, that's going to do it for this week's episode of Two Idiot Girls. Yes. Please keep making sure to send in your pet peeves because these are so funny, especially the middle finger one. That one threw me for a loop. Now I'm going to be like super self-conscious when I'm at the airport checking in.
I never use my middle fingers for that.
I'm going to try it just to see what it feels like.
But you got to do it like,
yeah.
You know what I mean?
And then I'm going to put it on the Two Idiot Girls story. Yeah. But we hope you enjoyed this week's episode. We are going on tour next year.
Yay!
The dates will be released next week. Yeah.
Next week.
So they haven't gone on sale. A lot of them have been asking. They haven't gone on sale yet, but you will see everything on Instagram. You'll know. You'll be very aware of it. Yeah. But other than that, we hope you have a great week. Make sure you watch the video version on our YouTube channel and the audio versions everywhere you can listen to podcasts. And we love you. Bye.
Bye.